In this video we are going to look into rendering settings in DAWS Studio. We will introduce you to the most important and useful settings and explain them. To begin, open the Render Settings tab. It is usually situated on the left side of the interface. If you can't find it here, you can always find all tabs in Window, Panes menu. The first tab in the rendering settings is General. Here we can set up the dimensions of our future render. It is done by selecting the resolution and aspect ratio. Also here you can choose whether you're rendering an image, or a movie, which means an animation. Choose the name of render file and its format here too. Second tab is Render Mode. Here you can choose between photoreal and interactive modes. While interactive is lower quality, but quite faster renders. Photoreal is the default render DAW and it is aimed at being realistic. Most often you would stay with photoreal anyway. The next tab, Progressive Rendering, is an important one. Here you can change what would basically be the quality of final render. Rendering is done in samples. Each sample takes time to render. The more samples there is, clearer and better your render would be, but also longer. For example, render with 5 samples looks very grainy. While render with 50 samples looks much better. Comparison speaks for itself. If you can't be bothered with counting samples, you can try using rendering quality. It is a feature that will stop rendering when DAWS 3D thinks that it is good enough. So if I render now, it will not reach 5,000 samples, but instead stop when render quality would be 95%. As you can see, it stops rendering at around 550 samples, because the image is already good enough. Or instead of this, you can simply set the time for a render in seconds. Alpha tab is what comes after. Here we can only change the default alpha LPE. This settings is needed for rendering transparent objects. We do not recommend you to change from the default specular transmission objects, unless you truly know what you are doing. Below is the optimization tab. The only important thing here is the caustic sampler setting. When you have something translucent and shiny on the scene, it can provide caustics. The caustic sampler doubles on this effect. Filtering tab allows you to put filter over your renders. Firefly filter gets rid of the white dots on the renders that are called fireflies. As you can see, it managed to hide some entirely. Others were made not to be so prominent. Fireflies are very nasty and this filter should be always on. Bloom filter simply adds bloom as post-production to your scenes. Without proper setting up, it will just make your renders blurry. The last but not least is the post-denoiser filter. This one is exceptionally interesting. It will try to remove all the noise out of your renders. Noise is the grain in fireflies that obstructs the image. But denoise filter will remove this problems and smooth out the image. Two images with same rendering time and samples, but one with the minimum amount of noise. Though be wary that too much denoising can wash out the details of your renders. Spectra rendering analyzes the components that make up the spectrum of light instead of faking it. This should presumably improve the color spectrum comparing to regular images. The natural spectral conversion and tint have really sharp color changes and objectively bad. The faithful option is better. Especially if you combine it with C1964 Spectral Observer. The C1964 variant looks brighter and more vibrant. Though it also took longer to render and a lot more noisy. So it is up to you, whether you prefer vibrant colors or faster renders with less noise. The next section objects part has again only one setting. This section caps enabled is needed only when you work with iRay section nodes. So let's skip this for now and move on. The second to last tab is tone mapping. Tone mapping is basically a post-production tab. Here you can do stuff like change film ISO and white point, crush blacks or change saturation. So here you can make changes to your render without changing your scene and lights. The last tab is environment. The main premise here is the environmental lighting. You can either use the sun sky lighting that is active here, or use HDRI by changing the environment mode to one of the two dome ones. Then select an environment map by clicking on the arrow, then browse and find an HDRI. This will change the environmental lighting of the whole scene. Settings below are focused around these changes. For example, you can rotate it or make it stronger. To learn more about environmental lighting and HDRIs, check links to our articles about them in description. Or check our channel, maybe we already did a video on it when you are watching this. For more overall information about rendering and render settings, check the DAWS 3D Render Settings, Basics and Tips article, link in description. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, to get more inspiration.